Hi, this video is part of GA4 in Lesson for Mini series where I talk about GA4 updates and change useful tips and tricks. In this video, I would like to touch on another important topic, namely incomplete data in GA4 reports, data discrepancies in GA4 and universal analytics reports, as well as other consequences of GA4 thresholds. So, everything you need to know without further ado in 4 minutes. What is thresholds in GA4? Google Analytics can remove some data from reports or exploration if the amount of the data collected does not meet a threshold value. Data thresholds are applied to prevent anyone viewing a report or exploration from inferring the identity of individual user based on demographics, interests, or other signals present in the data. Data thresholds are system defined, you can't adjust them. How to identify reports with the data thresholds? When threshold is applied to report or exploration, the data indicator change color. You can hover the indicator to see more information. When data thresholds are applied, Google Analytics can remove some data from report or exploration when Google Signals is enabled. What is Google Signals? Google Signals are session data from sites and apps that associates with users who have signed into their Google accounts and who have turned on ads personalization. But at the same time, this can cause some problems, example of thresholds. Well, it's worth adding that, for example, Google Signals does not support iOS 14 Plus and upward devices. When Google Signals might be good for you? If you want to start collecting demographic data in GA4 or use audiences based on the data to import it in Google Ads and then use it for marketing campaigns. Do not forget that will only work for users who have logged into their Google account and given permission to collect data. Along with that, you lose a significant amount of data in your reports. However, don't rush to turn them off. There are a few tips on how to get the benefits and get rid of the thresholds. First of all, reporting identity options. It's how Google Analytics measure users across devices and platforms. The super awesome part is the option you choose does not affect the data collection or processing. You can switch between the option at any time without making any permanent impact on data. If you don't implement a user ID on the site, just select a device-based method and enjoy unsampled data without thresholds. This method is similar to the one used in the Universal Analytics by default. Here is an example on how the data can change. Picture 1, thresholding applied. Picture 2, unsampled data. Look at how much the number have changed and how many new campaigns, searches, keywords, or anything else has been removed from the reports. In your case, the difference may last or even greater. You will see the difference in your report after changing the identity method, but in some cases, it may take up to 24 hours for the reports to become unsampled. Unfortunately, if you use a user ID, this option is not for you. There is no method that allows you to use user ID without using Google Signals. Think about whether you really need Google Signals in GA4. You may have already collected data and understand your audience. Now you can turn off Google Signals and get unsampled data. At least at the moment, I still hope that Google will add such a feature in the future to use user ID without Google Signals to get unsampled data. I hope this video was helpful to you. Thank you for your time and see you around.